The strength of a woman. Miguel?
Good evening, Erwin. A Ira, good evening to you, and a Ira, good evening to all our listeners, wherever in the world you are tuning in from. And as you said last week, you know, on Melbourne Motivation, we featured a brilliant young lady who was running for political office. So I thought it was only right that this week we feature another brilliant young lady who runs on the global stage, representing our beautiful island of Jamaica. So this week, our guest is none other than Miss Christine Day. Short bio, Christine is an Olympic track and field athlete who competes internationally for Jamaica. She competes and specializes in the 400 meter and 4x4 relay in the 2012 London and the 2016 Rio de Janeiro Olympic Games. Christine's 4x4 meter relay team took home silver medals. Her additional accomplishments include 4x4 relay gold medal in the 2015 Beijing World Championships, a 4x4 meter relay gold in the 2014 and 2018 Commonwealth Games, and a 400 meter bronze medal in the 2014 Commonwealth Games. Christine hails from St. Mary, Jamaica, and attended the University of Technology, UTEC. She is currently training to participate in the 32nd Olympic Games, set to take place this summer in Tokyo, starting July 23rd, running through August 8th. And so, Christine, welcome to Melbourne Motivation. And we greatly appreciate you taking the time out of your training schedule to have this conversation with us today. How are you feeling?
Good evening, everyone. I am really happy to be a part of this show this evening.
Excellent. And you know what? Let's start by saying thank you. And that is on behalf of the diaspora near and far, because the way you all on Team Jamaica represent us on the world stage, we all get a chance to be a little bit brighter with pride when we go anywhere in the world and say, yeah, my Jamaica, I'm gonna come from. And so we must say thank you, thank you, thank you. And can you take us, your child, when did you realize you had a passion for running, and was going to the Olympics your dream growing up?
Well, growing up, I just love competing. That's competition, high school, what you would say, no, sports day, stuff like that. But an Olympic dream at that moment, I wouldn't say that I was dreaming to be an Olympian at that time. Because at that time, it was all fun and excitement. But as I grew older, I realized that persons always saying stuff about me in terms of, you're talented, you know, and a professional athlete. And that was the turn for me at that age. I was about 18 years old when I was about to leave high school. And that was when my eyes started to turn to the track and field part of it as a profession. And that's how my journey begins.
Well, that's fantastic. Now, here you are. You know, you're a young woman from Tacky High School in St. Mary. And in the blink of an eye, you find yourself in the Olympics. Can you walk us through that journey? What is it like? Tell us about opening night. What are you thinking? What are you feeling? Take us inside that moment.
At the Olympic Games, that is?
Yes.
Okay, so that year, 2012, it wasn't a happy year for me in training, because I was having a lot of injuries and I wasn't confident in myself. And so for that moment, I just thought that I want to quit track and field. And I remember my best friend saying to me, which is Calice, she said I should give it a try, because it was like about 2 weeks away from the Olympic trials. And I wasn't so happy with her decision, but I go along with it. While I was there during competition, I started to compete very well, and that was when I really made my first Olympic team, and I am really happy about that.
Absolutely. So now I imagine here you are, not only are you in the Olympics, you're looking at all these other countries. Were you confident that, you know, we're there to destroy all the other countries? How was the other countries treating you all as Jamaicans?
Okay, for us as Jamaicans, you know that we are always the vibes of the party. For me personally, being a part of an Olympic Games was just a dream come true for me. And so for me, it was all like excitement. I was nervous about competing and I was just happy to be there. But you know, everyone wants to be around Jamaicans. And
yes.
Like opening ceremony was one of my best moments there, where, you know, a lot of countries want to be beside Jamaica. Because, you know, we always find something different other than all the countries. So there is always something different than just being there in ceremony. So you know that Jamaicans, they are very talented and we are very funny.
Yeah, man, just say it straight. Yeah, we bring the vibes. Yeah. So right now, you have your sights set on Tokyo. I'm not sure if many people know, but in Tokyo, Japan, this summer is the 32nd Olympic Games. And so how has your training been impacted by this pandemic and everything that's been going on for the last year plus?
For last year, I was impacted by the pandemic because, you know, this is a new virus and no one knows what this thing is about and everyone, you know, getting scared. But last 2020 was a little bit scary and rough because, you know, you lost competition, you're scared, you can't get to train properly. And so there were not a lot of preparation for this because no one expected a disease. But for this season, 2021, you learn about the disease. So there are a lot of things implemented. And so I wouldn't say the pandemic is affecting my training at this moment because I am able to train and I'm able to work out as best as I can right now. And to me, I believe that this is my best year in training.
Fantastic. It is said that an elite athletes have won and lost a million times before they get to the Olympics. Now, given your reality from a young age, enduring sacrifices and constantly finding ways to overcome setbacks, you even mentioned thinking about giving up on track, but you didn't, and you ended up hitting a big goal. What piece of advice or encouragement would you like to offer to anyone trying to figure out how to keep going in dealing with all the challenges that we've faced in the last year?
Okay, first you have to have confidence in yourself. And you have to be focused. That is one of the main things. You have to be focused and you have to be patient. Because this sport is very unfair. Like track and field is very unfair. And for me, it takes a longer time for me to actually be the athlete I am today. And for you to actually see, you know, like athletes progressing ahead of you, younger ones coming up and getting ahead of you, it can be very frustrating. And so you'd really have to focus on your dream, what you want to achieve, and not to look beyond like what others are doing, because it can really throw you off your game and you can actually just miss out on a big accomplishment. So I would say you have to be focused, you have to be determined, and you just have to just ensure that you know what you want and stop, you know, listening to side, you know, what others are saying behind you or beside you, but you have to really be focused.
Absolutely. I appreciate that. And you know what? You're a special athlete in that you're 10 plus years in, right? And so you have a kind of longevity that really is special. And to consider that here you are, despite all the challenges, you're still training as hard as you can. You feel like you have the best training you've had, you know, in your career, still during this pandemic. What is a piece of advice you would like to give specifically to the youth who would love to, you know, pursue a similar path, chasing their big dreams or their Olympic dreams? What kind of advice would you give to them?
Well, for the youths, it is something similar to what I said earlier. For the youths, I think you should enjoy the sport. You have to love it. You have to love it before you want to earn from it. And I think the frustration comes in when you are just looking at one part, one side of the of track and field. And of course, you run to make money, and you don't. It is not for fun. But you have to enjoy what you are doing, because if you don't enjoy what you are doing, there are going to be bad days in track and field. And I have a lot of bad days. And I am still here going on, going, keep on going, keep on going. So to me, they have to love it, enjoy it, and just grow in it. As you grow older, understand the sport more. So take your time to understand the sport. But I'm not taking away their competitive side. But just enjoy what you are doing. Let free. And as you as go along, you learn, and you know, you just enjoy the sport.
And that I love that advice, because so much is going on, and even as adults, we're trying to figure it out. And so we must consider the next generation and to pass it forward, as they say. And I want to talk a little bit about, take me back to your childhood, right? You know, where you grew up, Taki High School, St. Mary. You're a two-time Olympian, chasing three times. How has that even impacted your family legacy?
Okay, well, I believe that I am a hero in St. Mary. And I say that because I'm the only one from my high school right now who have gone this far in track and field. And everyone is proud of me. Well, I must say a lot of them are. And I think I motivated a lot of young girls growing up in the community. They admire what I achieved, and so they can dream along, you know, like they see that they are hope. Even though I grew up in a small community where you don't have stoplights and stuff like that, so just the entire community love and support. And I think being humble, having a humble background, I think that helped my path going forward.
Absolutely. And, you know, St. Mary, Taki High School, if you're listening, officially starting a petition, all right? We can change that to Christine Day High School. That's a beautiful name. But what I want to ask you about next is sort of how have you adjusted to going from a young girl who's trying to find her way in the sport to now one day you realize and recognize that you are a real inspiration to young girls, to your community, and to Jamaica at large? How was that transition for you?
Well, my transition, I think it bloomed right in front of my face without even me realizing that is what is happening to me. And for me, growing up, I was always a determined person. I love to win even simple debates. Even if I am communicating with you right now, I want to win that. So from a young age, I love to compete. And competition is not about just track and field. So I realized that the competitive spirit is always inside me. And really and truly, I think because of that drive that I had from a long time, it does come in naturally.
Indeed. And, you know, I want to say thank you again. I'm sure the entire diaspora, you know, is enjoying hearing this inside view. And, you know, there's something to be said about Team Jamaica and what you guys have done. Because when you look at it, and when track and field come up, Jamaica is, it's the first thought. And so what should happen in, as a diaspora, as a country, as a community, we have to get better at is ensuring that you guys get the sponsorship and the support that you deserve, because you guys have lifted us to the top of people's mind in the sport. And so how can people follow you, follow your journey? I'm sure there are some amazing sponsors out there who's getting excited to support, you know, you and your on your journey into 2020, Tokyo 2020, the 32nd Olympic Games. How can people stay in touch with you?
Okay, you can follow me on Instagram, which is Christine Day 40. That is my Instagram. And also my management team, which is Andy Sports Management. That is a Instagram page as well. That is my management team. And I'm on Twitter, like Christine Day 876. And so those are just the medium that you guys can reach me if you want to contact me about any sponsors.
Absolutely. We appreciate that. So we don't want to take up too much more of your time, but we do want to say thank you, thank you, thank you for taking the time to speak with us. And Erwin, you know, it is said that, you know, when our athletes are running, even crime and violence stop in Jamaica.
Indeed. Indeed. And I just want to touch base with her on something, because I think the last time she may have competed in high school at the Pen Relay was probably 2011, right? 2011, just about?
No, my last competition.
As a high school? The high school?
No, my high school.
Never went to Penn at that time, right?
One, so I didn't have a team.
Yes, yes, yes. But I must say, though, that you inspired them, because Taki has sent teams to the Penn Relays the years later. So
yes,
so the inspiration would have come from you, and we have hosted them at Team Jamaica Bickle, which we have hosted you as well when you have come with it, the national team as well. So we're very proud of you, proud of the spirit, proud of the heart. Not necessarily the biggest athlete physically on track, but the largest athlete in spirit on track. And so we appreciate what you have done for us as a true ambassador.
Thank you.
One love. Yes, Miguel. So, awesome lady.
Yes.
Awesome lady. Awesome lady.
Yes, Erwin. I figured you'd enjoy this one.
Indeed.
The master.
I just listen. When I see ambassadors speak, when I hear ambassadors speak, I listen, man, because I take notes too. And she has been a true ambassador. And so we thank you very much, Christine, and all the best to you in your endeavors. All right.
Thank you.
All right. Yes, Miguel, so thanks again for another exceptional motivation by Mr. Melbourne. And, you know, a very good subject indeed. She, as a champion, and again, the package physically small, but let me tell you.
Yeah.
The Talawa business, big.
Yeah. Oh, my God, the absolute definition, right?
Yeah, man.
Talk about bringing
Talawa. They're two athletes, right? Similar dimension, and the other one is a little smaller. I won't mention her name just now because she's going to kill me. She's celebrating her birthday soon. But when it comes down to being diminutive and being out there, nobody they burn the track, and whatever
Absolutely.
Is left behind, you step on coal, you know. So, so thank you very much, sir. So we catch you again next week. We'll talk. Next week is a very, very special day. And we'll probably be broadcasting from a different location. But we'll talk about that off camera. All right?
Most certainly. And so definitely for next week, of course, people can follow me on Melbourne Motivation on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube to see who is up next week. And, of course, you know my personal and professional mission is to impact the youth so that they can be prepared for college. So be sure to visit pathwaytopurposenyc.com. And use the code IRIE, IRIE, to get a discount when purchasing our college study flashcards.
All right.
So, Erwin, looking forward to connecting next week.
One love. And, of course, it's Melbourne Motivation right here in IRIE Talk Back every Tuesday. Miguel Melbourne. Thank you very much. Have a blessed week.
Blessed.
You're listening to IRIE Talk Back right here on 93.5.